Ugh, it's cold coffee.
Hi and welcome back.
We hope you all enjoy your break, and we're gonna start the episode of Cold Coffee with the birthdays.
Hope you all enjoy your birthday.
Now we're going to my favorite section, Millstone's Corner.
Drop Gang's Brothers!
3.
Woo, welcome back from vacation! I hope everyone had a great time. Seniors, no senioritis. Get your senior projects done. Everyone else, study hard. We've only got 6 weeks until the end of the semester, so you guys better work hard. See me if you need a tutor. Have a great day.
Thank you, Miss Millstone.
Now we're going to the most intellectual section and Paloma's favorite section, MB News.
The situation between Ukraine and Russia is still horrible, and something happened in April 8 in Kramatorsk.
A train station in Kramatorsk, Ukraine was attacked by rockets.
The results of this cluster strike were destruction of the railway station and 98 wounded civilians. Out of them, 16 were children, 46 were women, and 36 were men. They were all sent to the hospital. 38 people died in the scene, and 12 others died in the hospital later that day. And recently, thousands of people have used the train station to escape the east because Russia focused its military campaign on that part of the country.
Russia has denied carrying a targeted strike.
And later, Ukrainian President Zelensky dismissed Russian denials, saying, "This is an evil that has no limits."
We hope the conflict ends soon, and thank you for watching MB News.
Thank you, Dinis. That was pretty interesting. Also you, Bernie.
Next, we have Film Check, where JC is going to talk a little bit more about the Oscars.
Oscars 2022 Roundup Part 1. The winner for the best movie of 2021 was the movie Coda, which also won two other Oscars for Best Supporting Actor, given to Troy Kotsur, as well as Best Adapted Screenplay. Jane Campion won Best Director for her movie The Power of the Dog. You can watch it in Netflix now. The winner for Best Actress was Jessica Chastain from the movie The Eyes of Tammy Faye. Will Smith got in a small fight with Chris Rock and afterwards won Best Actor for his role in the movie King Richard. The winner for Best Supporting Actress was Ariana DeBose due to her role in West Side Story. You can watch it in Disney Plus now. The movie Dune won a total of 6 Oscars, including Best Original Score, Best Cinematography, Best Production Design, Best Visual Effects, Best Film Editing, and Best Sound. Best International Feature Film was won by the movie Drive My Car. Finally, the winner for Best Animated Feature Movie was Encanto. You can watch it now on Disney Plus.
Whoa, who knew there was more things in the Oscars rather than the Will Smith slap?
Next, we have Generation Points, where someone from each generation is gonna guess a flag.
Mm-hmm. No, Guyana, no, Guyana.
¿Por qué te la sabes?
Okay.
No hay.
No.
Bélgica, ¿no?
¡Ay, fue el único!
No, bueno.
Thank you, Generation Points. For everyone wondering, this is the new special edition ASFD Warriors t-shirt.
Next, we have Senior Life, where we're gonna show you a little bit about the only trip we're gonna take on spring break.
Thank you for all the seniors that sacrificed their break for such a good cause.
Next, we have Cooking Corner.
Thank you, Mara Inés. That looked good.
David. Ah, ¿ya estás grabando? Perdón, Jerry. Bienvenidos otra vez a Javisnes News. Hoy les voy a hablar un poco del proyecto de apiacultura. El Senior Project de Pia Michel, que está buscando salvar a las abejas.
Hola, soy Pia Michel y como parte de mi Senior Project estoy buscando concientizar a la comunidad de ASFG sobre la importancia que tienen las abejas y protegerlas. Por eso los invito a ver ¿Qué les pasó a las abejas?, un documental premiado mundialmente que será proyectado el martes 26 de abril a las 3:30 en el tercer piso. El documental muestra la lucha de las comunidades mayas apicultoras y refleja los daños de la industria agroquímica. Dura alrededor de una hora y muchos maestros van a dar puntos extras a quienes atiendan. Además, va a haber snacks gratis. Espero verlos ahí y para más información visiten la cuenta de Instagram de Apiacultura.
Hi, my name is Inés and this is Sofía and we're seniors. And this year for our senior project, we are planning the family day for staff, for the cleaning and the security staff.
It's gonna take place here at the ASFG. It's gonna be the Saturday, April 30th. And what we're looking for are 4 volunteers who can help us have a more organized event. So we're gonna give you the activities out and you're just gonna be watching out and making sure everything works. And like helping people, maybe painting their faces and different activities. Yes. You are gonna earn some service hours after this. So if you would like to participate, please contact us. Yes.
Thank you for watching this episode of Cold Coffee, and welcome to the new mullet season.